profession, I was able to fulfill a lifetime ambition, and that was to be in Doctor Who. And I played the prop in the Christmas special. The one that got sucked through the monitor.
My name is Louise Madison, and I played the Weeping Angel in Matt Smith's era, so I only got to meet one Doctor. But I've met plenty of them in the convention at this time.
Because there wasn't the time for it, so that's how fast it was. I'm just wondering if you have any good memories of being on the set with your parts when you were kids.
Yes. Yeah, I mean, I was really lucky. I was 12 years old. The perfect time to, to be a kid and have your dad at that age. It was just the coolest thing ever. You know, school, was fabulous. I got free sweets, I think the best memory I have actually is the trip to the Weber Theatre. I was lucky enough to go to Ealing and watch them blow up the big Dalek, which they couldn't do in the studio because it was too dangerous. And then I followed up and then went to the actual studio for a day. And I can tell you, the set, there's been an awful lot talked about this set, about the underground station, but it was stunning. It was unbelievable. So much so, you really did think there was going to be a train, coming down the track. And one of the assistants that I was with, he said, be careful, don't step on the live rail. I really believe that it was live. It was just incredible. Down to the detail of the set, I mean, on the station they had the chocolate machines and things like that. It was absolutely incredible. And best of all, meeting my favourite, the Yetis, which I think they should bring back, don't you? I mean, I think they're fabulous, they really are. And meeting the guys that operated them. Because in rehearsal they go around, with this furry bottle, and question producing. God knows what it was like on the transition, they must have been working buckets themselves. They were great, great memories. And I went to a couple of others, I think. Weber is probably my favourite. And I'm really pleased they brought out the remaster. I really love them.
Hello, this is for all of you. What's your favourite Doctor Who game?
I should start with you.
Weeping Angel. it's a tough one because Weeping Angel, I was an internist, so I did see them before becoming an angel. And it switched me up really badly. When it came through for the audition, they said I was going to be an angel. So I looked and I tried to see what kind of angels there were, and the only two options were the gold mask one, and they wear the robe. Or the weeping angel. I thought, I hope it's not the weeping angel because I don't want to have to watch that episode again because it scared me so much the first time. The gas mask children really terrified me as well. The Daleks are just brilliant. It would be my dream to be a Dalek. But I did try out a Dalek at the convention. I was so afraid of driving over people's toes. I wouldn't go very fast. So I don't know why doing this. I think they have a lot to do with in the Dalek.
I think the Dalek probably the real one that I was absolutely picked when I was a kid. They still haven't lost that really sort of terrifying, non-emotional kind of fear that they create. I think all of them are so good Daleks. But I have to say, the Yeti, a lot of people laugh at them, because they don't like, tubby bagels around. But actually, when I was 12, they we really did. So yeah, as far as monsters concerned, obviously the master in his various disguises is a key villain, probably is top. And Weeping Angel, absolutely terrifying. This idea that you look away and they've done something, you look back and it's a very, very clever piece of writing. Very clever.
I have to mention the Daleks because they are just terrifying memories and gave me plenty of nightmares and scared the pants of me every day when I was little. I didn't have to get up off the sofa for about 2 hours after the show whenever the Daleks were on. Also because my father was very nonchalant about the fact that I got a job in the Doctor Who, and I was very kind of very chuffed that I worked with the guy. So the fact that he was chuffed about it made me feel even better about the guy. But having my own personal nemesis, really, in the character of Phil, he literally was responsible for, my demise and my mind transplant. I think he'd have to be one of my favourites in that sense.